Colon cancer is the third most common and the second most deadly type of cancer. About 2 million new colon cancer cases are diagnosed worldwide every year, and 1 million people die from colon cancer every single year. While lung cancer kills about twice as many people as colon cancer, we know that about 90% of lung cancer cases are caused by smoking, so most lung cancer cases are preventable. But what about colon cancer? Can we reduce the risk for colon cancer by changing what we eat? Yes, let's see how. Remember to subscribe to our channel. 50 times lower cancer risk. There are large differences in colon cancer risk between populations around the world. In rural Africa, fewer than one person in 100,000 develops colon cancer. Whereas in the US, more than 65 people in 100,000 develop colon cancer. Migrant studies show the colon cancer risk of the immigrant population increases to that of the Western host population within one generation. Thus, our diet seems to play a crucial role in colon cancer risk. What are the differences between the rural African diet and standard American diet, or in general, between low-risk and high-risk diets? High-carb plant-based. A healthy gut microbiome plays an important role in the prevention of colon cancer. More on that later. So, the colon cancer rate might be related to fiber intake. Traditionally, the rural African diet has been very high in fiber and colon cancer rates were very low. But in recent decades, the average fiber intake has fallen to only 25 grams a day, comparable to Western dietary patterns. Still, colon cancer rates have remained low. There are two factors at play here. The modern African diet heavily relies on refined carbohydrates, like cornmeal. Thus, it is lower in fiber, but still high in starch, including resistant starch. Resistant starch describes those starch molecules that reach the colon without getting absorbed in the small intestine, and makes up about 5% of all starch eaten. Fiber and resistant starch both improve gut health. At the same time, the modern African diet is still very low in animal products, which also plays an important role in gut health. Healthy microbiota. Our gut houses trillions of bacteria of hundreds of different species. Their number and diversity grow or fall quickly, depending on what we eat. The pH value in our gut, how acidic or alkaline it is, plays a crucial role as certain reactions are amplified or inhibited depending on the pH value. A healthy gut is slightly acidic with a pH value below 6.5. So, how can we foster the growth of our good gut bacteria and decrease the gut pH value? Our good gut bacteria feed on fiber and resistant starch, producing organic acids, including short-chain fatty acids, which decrease the gut pH value. Our bad gut bacteria, which are in part putrefactive bacteria, feed on protein, producing alkaline metabolites like ammonia, which increase the gut pH value. pH and colon cancer. The pH value of our gut is closely linked to colon cancer risk. The lower the pH value, the lower the colon cancer risk, and vice versa. Ammonium ions that are present in more acidic environments are easily removed through the stool. A more alkaline pH value results in a higher ammonia burden on the body. Ammonia is carcinogenic and is also linked to a higher risk for breast cancer. The absorption of ammonia into our blood also puts a severe strain on our liver, which causes fatigue and many more problems. An alkaline environment coupled with oxidative stress also amplifies the formation of carcinogenic secondary bile acid. And indeed, a high-fat diet, which induces the release of bile acid, is linked to a higher risk for colon cancer. The danger of secondary bile acids can also be reduced by eating vegetables with bile acid-binding compounds, like beetroots or carrots. Two-week intervention. Changes in our microbiome can be seen within 24 hours of a diet change. In a study, Rural Africans eating the standard American diet, high in animal products and low in fiber, for 2 weeks experienced a 400% higher production of secondary bile acids and a 50% lower production of butyrate, a short-chain fatty acid that is an important energy provider for colonic cells. African Americans eating the rural African diet, high in starch and very low in animal products, for 2 weeks, experienced a 70% drop in secondary bile acid production and more than twice the production of butyrate. In another study, the average gut pH value of 7.4 at baseline dropped to a near healthy pH value of 6.7 on a vegan diet within only 2 weeks. The impact of such diet changes on colon cancer risk is enormous. Let's recap what we have learned about the impact of our diet on colon cancer risk. If we eat a diet high in fiber and resistant starch and low in animal products, we foster the growth and diversity of our good gut bacteria. We produce more organic acids, which reduce the pH value. Higher production of short-chain fatty acids improves our gut health. The low pH value inhibits the formation of harmful ammonia and secondary bile acids. Ammonium ions are easily excreted via our stool. Our colon cancer risk decreases. If we eat a diet low in fiber and resistant starch and high in animal products, we foster the growth of bad gut bacteria. We produce fewer organic acids and more ammonia, which increases pH value. We produce fewer short-chain fatty acids, which worsens our gut health. The high pH value increases the formation of harmful ammonia and secondary bile acids. Ammonia cannot be excreted and damages our gut and burdens our body. Our colon cancer risk increases. Dietary recommendations. What does a diet high in fiber and resistant starch and low in animal products look like? The best sources of fiber are whole plant foods, such as vegetables, fruits, intact grains, legumes, and nuts and seeds. Resistant starch can be found in starches, more when they cool down, grains and legumes. Getting more than 80% of calories from these foods is a great start. This ensures that you get plenty of fiber and resistant starch to build up and sustain a healthy gut microbiota. But do not increase your intake of fiber too fast. Animal products high in protein, hello putrefactive bacteria, and fat, hello bile acid, are not necessary for optimal health. You can find a lot of information on how to cut out animal products from your diet on our channel. Write us a comment if you have any questions. See you next week!